Hello, hi friends. This is Dr. Balu. Having 20 years of experience, I'm going to deal the subject digital circuits strictly according to the latest GATE syllabus. There will be a series of lectures in this channel. I will take you through all the concepts in the subjects digital circuits first and previous GATE practice problems followed by related tests so that the students will get through thorough and perfect learning to crack the GATE. In the last lecture, we discussed the concept of Boolean algebra. In this lecture, we are going to discuss some practice problems on Boolean algebra where the basic Boolean laws are applied to simplify the given expressions. Observe this problem. An expression is given a plus ab plus abc plus abcd plus and so on equal to how much? We need to simplify this one. If you take a common term here, in brackets 1 plus b plus bc plus and so on. We know that 1 plus anything is 1, then you will get answer a. Let us see here, a is a common term here, in brackets 1 plus b plus bc plus bcd plus and so on. That is 1 plus anything is 1. If you apply AND law, then it is a. So option c is correct. An expression is given a bar bc plus a b bar c plus a b c bar plus a b c. We need to simplify this one. See here, first and last terms. So bc is the common term. So here a plus a bar becomes 1. So we will get this expression. And observe these two first two terms here. The common term is c. If you take that one, so in brackets b plus b bar a, we know that a plus a bar b equal to a plus b. This is the redundant term. This is the redundant variable. So apply this formula. B plus b bar a is nothing but b plus a. So if you multiply, you will get this one. And if you observe the first and last term, the common term here is a. So in brackets, c plus c bar b. Once again, the same formula, a plus a bar b equal to a plus b. So we can remove this term c bar. So you will get this one. And on multiplying, you will get a b plus a c plus b c. Option c is correct. In this problem, an expression is given, that is f of p, q, r, s. Four variables are there. P q plus p bar q r plus p bar q r bar s. So if you observe last two terms, what is the common term here? P bar q. If you take that one, in brackets r plus r bar s you will get. Then you can apply the basic formula a plus a bar b equal to a plus b. And going on simplifying, you will get answer. Let us see. See here, in the last two terms, p bar q, if you take common, r plus r bar s is in the brackets. This r bar is a redundant lateral. We can remove that one, r plus s. So if you observe these two terms, first term and second term, the common term is q here, q. If you take that one, you will get p plus p bar into r plus s. This inside brackets, how it looks like? This a plus a bar b. Then we can remove this literal p bar. So in brackets, we will get p plus r plus s. If you multiply, you will get pq plus qr plus qs. And so option a is correct. In this problem, a Boolean expression is given. So here De Morgan's law comes into picture. Apply De Morgan's law for the last term. You will get xy bar whole bar into x double bar. Right? And multiply these two. You will get this expression. So We know that x into x is nothing but x, and y into y bar, the end law, zero. This term, it cancels zero. So for this term, apply once again De Morgan's law. So x bar plus y double bar is nothing but directly y. We can write x double bar directly. You can write x. Now in these first three terms, you take x is common, so 1 plus y bar plus y plus this, multiply this one, x bar into x plus xy. So we know that 1 plus anything is 1, so x is remains here, and we know that x bar x is 0. This term will get cancels. You will get x plus xy. In these two terms, take common x, in brackets 1 plus y. So we know that 1 plus anything is 1, so the x remains here. So option A is correct. In this problem, an expression is given. We need to simplify this one. So if you observe the last two terms, what is the common factor here? BC. If you take inside A plus A bar, right? So apply that formula, and going on simplifying, you will get the answer. See here, last two terms, BC term is taken. This term will become 1. And once again, the last two terms, what is the common term? B, in brackets C plus C bar A bar. Here you apply, we know that A plus A bar B equal to A plus B. C term is the redundant literal. We will get C plus A bar. And on multiplying, you will get BC plus A bar B. And here, if you take C is the common term, inside there A bar B bar plus B. Again, you apply A plus A bar B equal to A plus B formula. This literal is the redundant. So the remains is B plus A bar only here. So if you multiply this one, you will get A bar C plus BC plus A bar B. Option B is correct. The number of literals in the following expression is. What is a literal? It is a variable in either complemented form or uncomplemented form. It is known as a literal. For example, A is a variable, right? It is a literal, and A bar also a literal. That means complemented form, uncomplemented form. So observe here, A bar is one literal, B is second literal, C is third literal, and A is fourth literal, B bar is fifth literal. Because B and B bar, both are literals. And C, here it is repeated, no need to take. A is repeated here. And C is also repeated here. So total 5 literals are there. So option C is correct. In this problem, we need to find out the complement of XOR. We know that the complement of XOR is nothing but XNOR. But if they give some other expressions like that, what is the procedure to find out the complement of a given expression? So first, we need to find out the dual of the given expression and make complement each variable. See here, the XOR operation expression is A B bar plus A bar B. This is nothing but Y. So how to get the complement, which is nothing but Y bar equal to, find out the dual. Dual of Y equal to A plus B bar. That means what is the formula? The dot becomes plus, plus becomes dot. That is a dual of Y. So this, now this plus becomes dot here. A bar plus B. This dot becomes plus. This is the dual of Y. Now make a complement each variable, right? A means A bar plus B means B double bar. B double bar is nothing but B. Now, A double bar is nothing but A. And here B is there. We need to take B bar. So that is the complement of Y. Now you going on simplifying. Multiply this one. You will get A bar A 0. And B into B bar is nothing but a 0. And the remaining term will get A bar B bar plus AB, which is nothing but XNOR operation. In this problem, we need to find out the number of Boolean functions that can be generated by n variables. Concept for this we have seen in the last lecture. The answer here is 2^2n. Option D is correct. For example, there are two variables A and B. That means we can say that here n equal to 2. So if you apply in this formula, how many number of Boolean functions are possible? In this case, 2^2n equal to 2^2 is nothing but 2^4 is nothing but 16 Boolean functions that can be generated by two variables. In this problem, the number of self-dual functions that can be generated by n variables. The option is 2^2n-1. So option B is correct. Let us take the same example where A, B variables are there. N equal to 2. So 2^2n-1 that equal 2^2-1 that equal to 2^2-1 that is equal to 2^2, which is nothing but 4 self-dual functions can be generated by two variables. In this problem, an expression is given, that is A plus C into A bar plus B into B plus C equal to, we need to simplify here. So in general procedure, what you will do? Going on multiplying and applying basic Boolean laws to simplify this expression. Here, if you multiply first two terms, you will get A into A bar plus AB plus A bar C plus BC. We know that A bar is 0. So write a 0 here, the same expression. Now, remove this 0 and write this expression. And multiply these two terms. You will get this expression. In this expression, if you observe this B into B, you will get B only, so BC. C into C, you will get C only, that is BC. And once again, in these two, BC plus BC is nothing but BC only. And here also, if you take AB common, there is 1 plus C is there, we'll get 1. So the remaining term AB. So in these two terms, BC is common. So in brackets, 1 plus A bar is nothing but 1. So we'll get a remaining term AB plus BC plus A bar C. Consensus theorem says that there should be a 3 variables, each variable repeated twice, and where a 1 variable in complement form. Then we can apply consensus theorem, in which this A bar term is there and A term will be there, and this term is a redundant term. So answer is AB plus A bar C. Option A is correct. This also can be done in the shortcut procedure. Let us take this expression. So you can apply a consensus theorem here only. If you observe this one, this is there are 3 variables are there, each variable repeated twice, and 1 variable is in complement form. A bar is there, A is there, so this becomes redundant. So we can write it as A plus C and A bar plus B. Multiply this one, A into A bar is 0, so AB plus A bar C plus BC. You will get this one. And if you observe this one, once again, a consensus theorem, if you apply, then this is the redundant term here. Directly, AB plus A bar C, which is option A is correct. In this problem, PQR, three variables are there. This expression we need to simplify. So just going on multiplying and apply basic Boolean laws, you will get the answer. Write down the given expression, P plus Q bar, P into Q bar plus PR plus P bar, Q bar plus Q bar. This is the given expression. Now multiply first two terms. So P into P, we can take P, and P into P, we can take P, and Q bar into Q bar, we can take Q bar only. So this you can write. And if you observe these two terms, A plus A equal to A only. That's why P Q bar plus P Q bar, P Q bar we can write. And here in these two, what is the common term here? P Q bar. In brackets, 1 plus R you will get. Now this becomes 1 because 1 plus anything is 1. And multiply once again, you will get this one. And if you observe this one, P into P bar is nothing but a 0. And here P into P bar is nothing but a 0. So remove these two terms, you will get this one. So in this term, common term is PQ bar in brackets 1 plus R. This becomes 1. So answer is PQ bar. Option A is correct. So this is all about the practice problems on the concept of Boolean algebra, where the De Morgan's theorem and consensus theorem is very important. In the next lecture, we are going to discuss very important topic, that is sum of products and product of sums. Thank you very much.